Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Happy Father's Day.
Thank you.
Today is Sunday, June 21st, the 12th Sunday of Ordinary Time. As we honor our fathers today, we hear Jesus reassure his disciples by reminding them of the tender care of his Heavenly Father. Our Heavenly Father watches over us assiduously, faithfully, lovingly. Every hair on our heads is accounted for. Let us recall all the times our own fathers, grandfathers, uncles, and father figures, living and deceased, made us feel safe and secure with their vigilant care. Today's Mass intention is for William and Merrill Marston. Please let us read our sovereign Father Victor.
Thank you.
terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped. Then we will prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me, like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble. They will not triumph. In their failure, they will put to utter shame, a lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe mind and heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them. For to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord. Praise to the Lord. For he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please repeat. Lord, in all your great love, answer me.
Lord, in all your great love, answer me.
For your sake, I bear insult, and shame covers my face. I have become an outcast to my brothers, a stranger to my mother's children, because zeal for your house consumes me, and the insults of those who blaspheme you fall upon me. Lord, in your great love, answer me. I pray to you, O Lord, for the time of your favor, O God. In your great kindness, answer me with your constant help. Answer me, O Lord, for bounteous is your kindness. In your great mercy, turn toward me.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
See, you lovely ones, and be glad. You who seek God, may your hearts revive. For the Lord hears the poor, and his own who are in bonds, he spurns not. Let the heavens and the earth praise him, the seas and whatever moves in them.
Lord, in your great love, answer.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, through one man sin entered the world, and through sin death. And thus death came to all men, and as much as all sin. For up to the time of the law, sin was in the world. Though sin is not accounted where there is no law. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin, after the pattern of the trespass of Adam. It was a type of the one who was to come. But the gift is not like the transgression. For if by the transgression one of the many died, how much more did the grace of God, and the gracious gift of the one man, Jesus Christ, overflow in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
What I said to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body. In cows sold for a small coin, yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my Heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my Heavenly Father. Sisters and brothers,
the good news of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
The life or the behavior of our dear ones? Why? Because we are ashamed to share that behavior in the world among others. And Jesus says to us this morning, do not be afraid. Why? Because everything hidden will one day be made clear. Our Father in heaven knows all. Our Father in heaven understands all. And yes, he urges us not to allow fear to get the better of us. So the first thing is the hidden fears of our lives. Secondly, there is fear of dangers from the outside. Fear of war. Fear of the breakdown of law and order. Fear of growing violence. And Jesus says to us once again, do not be afraid of those who can kill the body but cannot kill the soul. We have a Father who cares for us. And to this Father, we matter. We matter to God our Father. The third fear is fear that we are so small. That is, we as individuals fear that we are so small. Fear that we are so insignificant. Or fear that we are so unimportant. So we feel lost in the face of the immensity of the universe. Yes, lost like a speck of dust amidst the billions of people who inhabit this universe. So we find it hard to believe that God, with this vast, busy universe to look after, can afford us anything more than a total divine attention. But Jesus says again, you are worth more than hundreds of sparrows. Hidden fears. Fears from the outside. And fear that we are insignificant. In the face of all this, Jesus says, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. And these words are especially powerful because the one who speaks them to us is our Father. The one who speaks them to us really knows us. The one who speaks them to us, loves us so much. And who we love, he is afraid that we can trust. You know what it is? Life without friends. Life without friends will make me intolerable. As a matter of fact, couples, to really live a meaningful married life, they all have to see the other as a friend. As a friend that has a partnership. A friend that we can trust. Life without friends, as I say, is intolerable. And it is in the light of all that human friendship means that we can cry out in the words of that old hymn, what a friend we have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins that breathes to him. What a privilege to come. Everything to God. never be disappointed. You should never be disappointed. We can't find a friend so faithful. Jesus knows our every weakness. So we take it all to God, to Jesus in prayer. Often, we cannot understand why things happen as they do. Sometimes we suffer. And sometimes we are glad because of the evil of others. But sometimes we are glad too because of the goodness of others. And then it is quite clear to us why things are as they are. But often things have no explicable reasons. Things that happen in your life, in my life, in the life of those around us, sometimes there are no explicable reasons for them, why they happen. We have the common question people do ask, why do we, or why do bad things happen to good people? Why do some people go through endless tragedies, while others through life go through life with comparatively little unhappiness? In the words of Pope Francis, we can apply that statement to this situation. Who are we to judge? Why does this happen? Why do the most appalling tragedies often seem to happen to those least able to deal with them? Car accidents, sudden sickness or death of a loved one, like we see again every day, and some of us have experienced of our families due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Why? And when you hear stories about this pandemic, you see, yes, in a particular family, no one is touched. But in some families, you hear 3, 4. Why? Why? How do we explain that? Sometimes our lives seem so fragile. And it does feel like a wind of dead leaves blown away. In the face of all this, Jesus' words this morning are insistent. Do not be afraid. Take heart. Never forget that God loves you. Never forget that God loves you. Think about it. Very, very motivating and inspiring. Because you know that someone cares, even in human terms. When you know that someone cares for you and you see their actions, even without their presence, physical presence, you know within you, when you think about it, that yes, there is someone there for me. So imagine God, who is our Father, who is the Creator, who made you, and knows all that you are. And as we hear in today's gospel, can count all the hair in your head. Let's look at it. For those of us who have hair, you see, Mr. Buckley laughing because there's no hair in his head. But yet, God knows. He knows the roots of your hair, Mr. Buckley. So God knows. All we need to do is respond. We know that it is very hard, but perhaps it is only when we can learn to completely abandon, surrender ourselves to the love of God, and when we can accept both joy and suffering as gifts from God, not just the good things in life. But it's actually easy. Everything, good or bad. Surrender all to God. But surrender with faith and trust. Not just surrender because, oh, I'm a Catholic, I'm baptized, so I surrender to God. It means nothing. Surrender to God with faith and trust. All of our life, no matter the shades of that life, no matter the ups and downs of that life, is a gift from God. But some of us who don't have faith, we say, how can that be a gift when my life is going downhill? You tell me that's a gift from God. That's part of the mystery of the government. All of our life is a gift from God. We cannot move or breathe or think or smile without God. He holds us in being and He holds us in His grace. And He fills all that we do. So nothing that happens to us happens without the knowledge and awareness of our God. That is why in today's gospel, Jesus tells His disciples, take heart. He tells them to take heart and not to be afraid of the difficulties and the dangers that might befall them. Even under the threat of persecution, under the threat of death, they need not fear, He says, because God so loves and cares for them that they can never fall away from His embrace. We cannot stop God from loving us. Just think about it. We cannot stop God from loving us. We as human beings can stop the other person from loving us. We know what to do. And that person just hates us. No matter what we do, we cannot stop God from loving us. However much we reject Him, however much we betray Him, or however much we ignore Him, yes, we do that all the time. When things are good, in good times, oh, God becomes very distant. But when things seem to overwhelm us, the dangers of life, the burden of life begins to overwhelm us, that's when, praise God, don't look for Him. But we should look for Him and be with Him all of the time because He is there for us. So however much we reject Him or betray Him or ignore Him, it is His love pours out upon us steadily and continually. Yes, we may deserve God, but He will never deserve us. So today, as we celebrate this Mass, let us take courage. Let us take courage then and abandon ourselves, surrender ourselves to the love of God. Let us trust in God and through all our joys, all our sorrows, let us stop believing that He loves us. Only when we do can we acknowledge the relationship that He has with us. And we acknowledge and come. Well, I'm speaking humanly, and we have Him to help us. Because He's always there, and we will open up to Him. We will feel His presence in our lives. So sisters and brothers, we'll go home today at the end of this celebration with these words, be not afraid. All is well. All is well.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ. came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became flesh. For our Savior was crucified, and was crucified, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord and the Lord of life, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess upon baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Sisters and brothers, we call to mind our roots, assured that God knows and cares for us, and every single detail of our lives, right now to each day and our lives.
Please respond. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That all of us across this planet, our common home, may take the steps necessary to making the earth a livable, bountiful, and beautiful home for generations to come. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all our fathers, father figures, who have loved and guided us throughout our lives, those who are living, and those who have passed on to eternal life, that they may always enjoy God's loving care. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of us in this faith community, that God may shelter us from all our fears and comfort us in our distress. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who are suffering or are sick on account of COVID-19, that the message of God's love may bring them comfort in their distress and inspire others to provide care and understanding. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the souls lost through the coronavirus, that they may find eternal rest and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For George Floyd and Rashad Brooks, that their deaths will not be in vain, but lead to significant changes in policing and our criminal justice system. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all of our intentions spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For women and men from sin, for whom we are often distressed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Loving God, may God bring care and compassion for the people. Inspire us to be generous with our care and compassion for all those that we need. We make this prayer for all of our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Give thanks. Praise the Lord.
receiving away with himself all the glory to the chalice, and once more giving thanks and giving to his disciples, saying, take this for me and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of God.
Amen.
touch. Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Lord, now on our sins for all our faith, and graciously grant us your peace and unity in accordance with your holy will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Amen.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son Jesus, we ask for the merciful Lord that what we celebrate with constant devotion, we may work our may be our short pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
At this point, we honor our Father's Day. We're going to ask Mr. Butler, Charlie Butler, to come forward. I think he has a poem for our fathers, fathers of the fathers, and the fathers of the day.
Good morning, church family. I've been invited today to say a couple of words on behalf of the St. Aloysius Church and its ministry. First, I'd like to thank Father Victor for providing us with the spiritual nourishment and mentorship that we need on a daily basis, and he does it in the spirit of fatherhood. The end of life. I also would like, on behalf of the men's ministry, to pay honor and tribute to all of the fathers and grandfathers, the uncles and brothers that stand in the gap when there is no father there. And that's past and present. I want to remember those that have gone before us, those fathers and grandfathers. And also to remember those that have gone before us, either due to the coronavirus or the violence, or those lives that are gone because of the violence of police brutality that we've been experiencing lately. I had a good friend of mine who happens to be my brother from another mother. God blessed him with the gift of the power of the pen. And so I asked him to put a point together for this occasion. His name is Dr. Robert Watts Wills. And the title of the point is, what is a man? What is a man? He is the image of the Creator. He is the tent where the Spirit of the Lord dwells. He is the tent where the Comforter visits, searching the hearts for the unconscious prayers. He is a spiritual being having a human experience. He is the one with dominion. He is the symbol of the Father's love for his creation. What is a man? He is the Lord's sheep. Leading in the darkness of the valley, he is a sheep at peace in the arms of the shepherd. What is a man? He is a father to the children gifted to him. He is a model of the first man, the one who gave birth to his helpmate. He is the one commanded to love her. He is the one commanded not to forsake her for no other. What is a man? He is the father that shall not provoke his children. What is a man? He is the beloved. washed in the blood of Christ. He is a king and a priest. In the order of Melchizedek, he is the one to be loved and honored by his children all the days of their lives. What is a man? He is honest, he is trustworthy, he is courageous in the face of fear. He is forgiving, he rejoices in the name of the Lord. He is kind, he is faithful, he is powerful in his humility. He is repentant. What is a man? He is the leader of his family, he is dependable. He eats grass, if need be. He is consistent in the face of uncertainty. He is not perfect, but strives to be the face of Christ. What is a man? He causes his children to feel safe. He makes them sing with greed and presence. He makes them weep at the court of his transition and celebrate knowing that he waits to be in the presence of the Creator. What is a man? He is a reminder of God's righteousness. He is his brother and sister's keeper. He is a father of orphans. He is you. He is me. Happy Father's Day.
Now I'm going to say a prayer on this day and this Father's in the name of all fathers, and particularly the fathers of our parish. For our fathers who have given us life and love, and we may show them respect and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For fathers who have lost a child through death, that their faith will give them hope and their family and friends support and console them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For fathers who have died, that God will bring them into the joy of his kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, in your wisdom and love, we made all things. Bless these men, that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them all with the spirit of profound respect through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I hope you guessed it very well.
Go, Father, go.
Now that is going to sing a song of our heart.
Thank you. Thank you.
We want to call it Mrs. Coakley, Mrs. Butler, and of course, Mrs. Butler, and that, Danny. Bienvenido. And our able Dave, our pianist, organist. And today we